Today, we're building a flexible screen in the form of a beaded curtain encrusted with LEDs. It's using a pixelBlaze Wi-Fi microcontroller, so I can control the animations remotely on my computer or phone. Hey, it's Becky, and I've had this project on my list for quite some time. The idea is simple. Run lots of LEDs in vertical strips, enough to form a curtain. So I started with an existing beaded curtain to use as my substrate. I figured I could use the bead strands to attach the LEDs so they don't have too much strain. I picked up the multitude of LED strands and necessary beefy power supply at DigiKey, the sponsor of this video. On their site, you can find a huge variety of components and tools for your own projects. If you're a beginner, don't miss my introductory electronics series on the DigiKey YouTube channel. It'll bring you up to speed on all the wiring and soldering techniques you'll need to build your own LED curtain. Ideally, there would be a bunch of strands coming down from the top, but these pixels are best wired in a single data chain, so that would require soldering at the top of each strand, as well as a long data wire connecting the end of each strand to the top of the next. So I opted to wire mine in a zigzag pattern, linking two strands at the bottom as well as the top. We'll see how this ends up affecting the curtain in the end. These strands are pretty close together. This makes for the least soldering possible, only where it's needed to connect the termination of one strand with the beginning of another, and that's just because I don't like the look of these big black clips. I attached the LED strands to the beaded strands with plain sewing thread, tying individual double knots around one or more of the wires as well as the string in between the beads. I had to set up my soldering iron nearby the curtain and make sure to attach the next strand before the end of the previous one gets too short or it wouldn't reach. This process was not too quick, but it was fun to toil over while the LEDs were on. I attached a secondary power and ground to the end of the last LED strand, then connected up all the LEDs to test them and double check that everything was getting enough power. Trimming all those threads is giving me flashbacks to my beaded chandelier project, which still doesn't have all its threads trimmed, if I'm being honest. When I put this project on my long list of things to make, I could swear there weren't LED screen-like curtains available for purchase, but now there are.
I really should have waited until I finished wiring my DIY LED curtain before I put up the one I bought from China. I've lost all motivation.
So if you are satisfied with the size and the animations that come preloaded on this thing, maybe buy the off-the-shelf version. It's definitely cheaper. But if you want to make entirely custom and very sophisticated looking animations, the handmade one has the advantage. After hanging it in the doorway and trying it out, it's pretty obvious that the connections at the bottom impact the ease of walking through it, big time. This could be mitigated by tying threads in between connecting strands every so often, so the two strands pull apart more as one unit. Or, I'm just gonna put it on a flat surface like a window instead of a door. But it is successful by the metric of projects my 13-year-old self would love. If I were to take this further, I might try to reverse engineer the store-bought version to see if it's possible to replace the microcontroller. Then I'd have the best of both worlds with purpose-built function and high-class algorithmic fashion. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with a friend. I hope you'll subscribe to the bell to be notified of my future uploads, subscribe to my email newsletter, and find me on your favorite social media network. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. This video was made with support from my sponsors and with generous donations from viewers like you through Patreon and YouTube memberships.